Hello, my name is Neil Bobbie from McMaster University. I'm going to be discussing today the benefits and consequences of space technology and exploration as it impacts the lives of people here on Earth. I intend to start a discussion of the priorities of world organizations and whether the current approach is sustainable. In 2012, about $25 billion Canadian dollars was spent by space agencies around the world. Approximately $17 billion of that was from NASA, $5 billion by European Space Agency, and the rest split between China, Japan, India, Russia, Iran, and Israel. Since NASA's conception in 1958, the USA Office of Management and Budget estimates that NASA spent about $800 billion when accounting for inflation. That's nearly $1 trillion over 50 years. Of course, not all of this money is directly related to space exploration. About 20% of this $800 billion was used for administration, facility maintenance, and education, among other things. Still, over 50 years, that averages about $13 billion per year that NASA spent on space exploration. What has been done with that money? Quite a lot, actually. NASA alone is responsible for many advancements in health and medicine, transport, public safety, consumer goods, computer technology, and industrial productivity. NASA was integral in establishing satellites in various orbits around the Earth. This has had huge impacts in the fields of communications, navigation, television, astronomy, reconnaissance, and weather monitoring. We see improvements in our lives directly from these technologies. But what was the opportunity cost? What did we have to give up in order to get these things? Life on Earth could be improved substantially for the current cost of space exploration. Let's work with the $17.7 billion 2012 budget of NASA. Let's take a look at what that would compare to in terms of improving human life. The 2004 Copenhagen Consensus estimated costs of large-scale projects that would yield improvement to quality of life for human beings. They found that $13 billion per year for 4 years would significantly reduce the effects of malaria worldwide. $12 billion per year would be enough to provide micronutrients to everyone on Earth, thus eradicating malnutrition. And $3.4 billion per year for 8 years would be enough to prevent 28 million new cases of AIDS worldwide. These world problems could be solved within the budget of just NASA. In fact, the UN estimates that for about $75 billion per year, we could provide clean drinking water, basic sanitation, basic healthcare, and basic education to every single person on the planet, significantly increasing the minimum quality of life on Earth. Of course, it is very naive to believe that just throwing money at the problem would be enough to eradicate it. Corruption is a large issue in many developing countries. But hopefully, these figures give you an idea of the scale of the problems that we face, and how close we could be to solving them. In closing, I'd like you all to stop and think. If we could reduce the worldwide space exploration budget by 50% for just 10 years, we could easily be able to significantly improve quality of life for hundreds of millions of people worldwide. This fact should make us stop and take a hard look at our current priorities regarding space exploration. Thank you.